Morning students, today we will discuss about the noun, that is the first chapter in English, as you have read about noun in your previous classes. Now first let's talk about the definition of noun. A noun is the name of places, person, things or animals. For example, girl, boy, painter, playground, school, fan, table, tiger, dog and many others. As you can see here, girl, boy, painter refers to the name of person, whereas playground and school refers to the name of place. Fan, table refers to the name of things, whereas tiger and dog refers to the name of animal. Now let's talk about the types of noun. There are 5 types of noun. First is common noun, second proper noun, third collective noun, fourth concrete or material noun, and last one is abstract noun. Let's look what each types of noun is with examples. Number first is common noun. Common nouns are used to name people, places or things in general. Means the general name of anything is common noun. For example, this boy is very intelligent. My house is red in color. In the above two sentences, the underlined word, that is boy and house, are common noun as they are general names of person or things or place. Proper noun. Proper nouns are used to name a specific person, place or things. Means the special name of anything is proper noun. For example, Amrita is my best friend, Chennai is a big city and the discovery of India is a good book. Here, the underlined words are common noun. Note, proper nouns begin with the capital letter as you can see here also. Collective noun. Collective nouns refer to a set or a group of people, animals or things. For example, there is a bunch of keys in my cupboard, a swarm of bees. As you can see here, keys is a set of thing, whereas bunch is collective noun. Same here also, bees, group of animals and swarm is collective noun. Now let's talk about fourth one, that is a concrete noun or material noun. Concrete or material noun refers to the substance of which things are made of. They can be seen or felt by one or of our senses. For example, gold is the most valuable material. Honey is a good for health. Honey is good for health. Here the underlined word gold and honey are the example of concrete noun. Now let's talk about the abstract noun. Abstract noun refers to the names of feeling, qualities, virtues. For example, sincerity is the second name of virtue. Honesty is the best policy. Here sincerity and honesty, which is underlined, are the examples of abstract noun. Abstract nouns cannot be seen, touched, heard, smelt or tasted. Nouns, forms of adjective, verbs or common nouns are usually abstract noun. As you can see here, brave is adjective, but bravery is abstract noun. Happy is adjective and happiness abstract noun. Same here also, die is adverb, but death is abstract noun. Now, no knowledge. Now see here, leader is common noun, whereas leadership is abstract noun. Friend, common noun, friendship is abstract noun. From this video, I hope you all have understood noun and its type. Thank you. Student, so in the previous video, you all have understood about noun and its type. In this video, you are going to read countable and uncountable noun, singular, plural form and about gender. So basically, countable and uncountable noun. Countable nouns that can be counted, but uncountable noun that cannot be counted. Means countable noun ko hum log count kar sakte hai, but uncountable noun ko hum log count nahi kar sakte hai. Okay, countable noun have a singular as well as plural form, but uncountable noun do not have nouns do not have a plural form. इन लोग ये countable singular form में भी होता है, plural form में भी होता है. For example, one hat singular form, two hats plural form. But in uncountable plural form uncountable noun का नहीं होता है. For example, one milk, two milks is wrong. 1 liter of milk is correct. 2 liters of milk is correct. So basically we cannot count the milk, but we can measure the milk. So 1 liter of milk, 2 liters of milk. Now countable nouns have two forms. First is singular form, second is plural form. Singular means one, whereas plural means more than one. For example, rat. Rat is singular, but rats, plural. Wolf, singular. Wolves, plural. Now see gender. Basically, gender is divided into 4 types. Masculine, feminine, common and neuter. So what is gender? Gender is used to differentiate noun and pronoun in as masculine, feminine, common or neuter. Basically gender hum log use karte hain so that we can differentiate between noun and differentiate noun and pronoun into masculine, feminine, common or neuter. First we'll talk about the first type of gender, that is masculine. What is masculine gender? A male member of a species is a masculine gender. Noun means noun referring to males are said to be a masculine gender. So for example, basically what we have understood, male जो नाउन मेल को रेफर करता है उसे हम लोग मैस्कुलिन जेंडर बोलते हैं. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, अंकल, किंग, बुल, ही, हिम, एक्सेट्रा. हियर अंकल, किंग, बुल आर नाउन्स, वेयर एज ही एंड हिम आर प्रोनाउन. सेकेंड इज फेमिनिन जेंडर. अ फीमेल मेंबर ऑफ अ स्पीसीज is a feminine gender noun. Means noun referring to females are said to be the female feminine gender. Or you can say a noun that denotes a female is called feminine gender. For example, aunt, queen, cow and many others. She, her. Here aunt, queen, cow are the examples of noun, whereas she and her are pronoun. Number third is common gender. A common gender noun is used for either or both males or females. Yes, for example, मतलब ऐसे nouns जो males में भी used हो सकते, वो refer करता है male को भी as well as female को भी. Like for example, leader, student, teacher and etc. I, me, you. Here, if you will see teacher, मैम भी होती है, सर भी होते हैं. सो इट्स रेफरिंग, इट डिनोट्स मैस्कुलिन ऑल्सो, फेमिनिन ऑल्सो. मेल भी डिनोट करता है एंड फीमेल भी डिनोट करता है. सो बेसिकली दीज आर द एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ कॉमन जेंडर. नंबर लास्ट इज न्यूटर जेंडर. अ न्यूटर जेंडर इज नाइदर अ फीमेल नॉर अ मेल. मीन्स बेसिकली इट्स अ नॉन लिविंग थिंग. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, कार, fan, computer, it, etc. That's all for today. Thank you. I hope you all have understood this. And this is a revision of nouns and its type, singular, plural and gender. So students, please be sincere and revise these topics for test. Thank you.